former UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon calls for more action to achieve the goals of the Paris Climate Change Agreement during his visit to the Philippine Senate. Our correspondent Willard Chang now on the line with that story. Willard?
Hi, Ron. Former United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon visited the Philippine Senate and called for global solidarity and increased effort to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals and implement the Paris Climate Change Agreement. Addressing the Senate plenary, Ban said much work is still needed, pointing out that progress in achieving some of the goals has stagnated and even reversed in some sectors. He also underscored the role of the United Nations in pursuing peace and security, human rights and development, saying its values and principles should be replicated, as exemplified by UN peacekeepers, aid workers, and health specialists.
Our work is certainly not done yet. Indeed, climate crisis, pandemics, regional conflicts, as well as economic crises disrupt the human species. Human societies, our progress on achieving the 17 sustainable goals ahead of their 2030 target date has stagnated. In some sectors, it has reversed. At the same time, our climate action on the road to set to net zero emission by 2050 lacks the requisite urgency to meet the moment. This is why there has never been a more vital time in history to come together in cooperation, partnership, and solidarity to redouble our efforts to achieve the Sustainable Development Goals and implement the Paris Climate Change Agreement. We simply must prioritize global action at all levels.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri said this was the first time a visiting foreign dignitary addressed the Senate during its session. Coinciding with Ban's visit, the Senate adopted and ratified proposed Senate Resolution No. 936 for the agreement between the Philippines and the Global Green Growth Institute, establishing the GGGI office in the Philippines. The Senate also passed Senate Resolution No. 929, filed by Senate President Pro Tempore Loren Legarda, honoring the 8th UN Secretary General and commending his outstanding global contributions. Ron, back to you.
Willard Chang with that story. Thanks, Willard. State Weather Bureau Pagasa says a total of 51 provinces in the Philippines are currently experiencing the effects of the El Nino phenomenon. Based on latest data, 24 provinces are facing drought, 17 are experiencing dry spell, and 10 provinces are under dry conditions. Pagasa notes El Nino will likely persist until June 2024.
Pagasa came up with a general statement that mature El Nino is expected to continue and show signs of weakening. And majority of global climate models suggest that El Nino will likely persist until March, April, May, and then back to ENSO neutral condition in April, May, June.
Meanwhile, officials from the Philippine Agriculture Department paid a visit to the town of Bulalacao in Oriental Mindoro, which is under a state of calamity due to severe drought. DA spokesperson Arnel De Mesa says about 1,300 hectares of farmland were affected in the province. The officials, however, assure residents there help is on the way. The Philippine Air Force says it may conduct cloud seeding operations in Benguet Province this week to help suppress the forest fires there. Last week, the Air Force had deployed two of its helicopters to the forests of Benguet and Ilocos Norte to fight the fires. Each heli bucket contains 800 liters of water, but this was not enough to suppress the blaze. More than 300 hectares of forest land have been affected by the fires, some of which are yet to be contained.